Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I'm going to cover a new feature from C++ 23 that is very simple, seems extremely simple, but we'll talk about the motivation for it and why it was added to the standard. Be sure to check out the video description for links to my ebooks, printed books, Patreon, and GitHub sponsor page, as well as news about upcoming events that you might be interested in. So this is a C++ 23 feature, and I do have the compiler here in C++ 23 mode, and I am on GCC trunk for that reason. This is going to seem silly at first, but we'll talk about the motivating example. So let's just say I've got an integer and I want to make a copy of it. I can, in C++ 23, use this construct to say explicitly make a copy of this value. Now, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense here in this case, but it kind of makes sense in the case of, well, template-y things. If I need an explicit copy of something, then I can do this. I can make a copy here on line 7. But since this is a auto template parameter, if I wanted to avoid the explicitly named thing, I have to do something kind of like this. And well, that's needless to say a mouthful of code to write. But we can do this. I'm going to, from here, show the motivating example from the paper that added this to the standard. Now, I've gone ahead and just pasted this in, and the idea is, say I've got some container of strings, and I want to erase everything that happens to match the first value. I pass this into a function, some reusable tool, whatever it does, what I need it to do, and I say standard erase. Now, we already covered that. That's C++ 20's uniform container erase function. So I pass in the container and I say, I want you to erase everything that matches this value, which is container.front. So I want it to remove, in this case, this test3 value. So we just should expect test3 removed, test3 removed, and then hello there world, and then Bob, and then test, and then hello world. So we should expect 4 responses back, and we pass in 6. And we can see right over here, I do have the program running and showing its output, and I have hello there world, Bob, and test. Somehow, we lost an extra copy of hello there world. And if I put it in here a third time, I'm afraid to say that we will probably lose another copy of it. Now, this has a very interesting accidental property, but it's definitely not doing what we want it to do. And in here, it's not even consistent. It's not just removing all duplicates. But what has happened is the standard erase function, it takes a value by const reference. So I am passing in a const reference to the first element. Now, erase is going to use the remove if algorithm internally, which doesn't ever actually erase anything. It's doing swaps. So as it's swapping values around and saying, I want you to remove anything that matches this front value, it's going to take this and it's going to swap it to the end. And then it's going to check the next thing and it's going to swap that to the end. And then it's going to check the next thing. But in this process of swapping things around, it's going to end up overwriting that front value. And now the thing that it's comparing against has actually mutated during the execution of the algorithm. This is not a good way to have predictable behavior from your algorithms. So this motivating use case is to say, I need a copy, please, of that front object so that I can have expected behavior for my call to this algorithm. And it works. So it removes everything that matches test 3, but it leaves the rest of the code here. And if I were to put in another copy of test 3, I should expect to see it properly removed from the output. So it's really that simple. It's a guaranteed, built-in, simple way of explicitly requesting a copy of an object that it was given. And you could do it something like this if you wanted to. But it's built into the language, and it's a handy way of doing that now in C++ 23. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of C++ Weekly, and be sure to subscribe, of course. And give this video a thumbs up. That always helps.